Yeah, good morning everybody. After some technical tips and tricks, we are going to have some different topic, and it is very useful to become a faculty as well as to become a good orthopedic surgeon or to become a successful practitioner in our life or to avoid litigations in our practice. So communication skills for doctors is very important, where art meets the science. Why it is so important? Human being is the only blessed with the ability to speak. No other species have this privilege. How to communicate in proper way is an art. It differentiates the successful people from the unsuccessful people. What is the importance of communication? Orthopedic practice is not only science, but it is also art as well as commerce also. Communicating properly with patients, relatives, and even with our colleagues is very important in day-to-day practice. Soft skills are equally or more important than hard skills in orthopedic or medical practice. This is not taught in our medical colleges. Basically, we are not taught this in medical colleges. We need to learn and develop these skills over a period of time for a successful professional career. About faculty orientation program, I have talked already in the morning. It is a very useful concept. We at MOA believe in decentralization of the academics and administration. This is an innovative concept, and you are enjoying this since the morning. The 5 such programs will be taken in every region every year, and there will be basic as well as around. This is basic course. I have attended the New Age Arthropod course at Mumbai, where Neeraj and their faculty. We can have some advanced course in the next year also, or next year. So whether it is a faculty or whether it is a practice, the crux of matter is a good speech should be like a woman's skirt. Long enough to cover the subject and short enough to create the interest. That is the crux of the situation, whether it is a practice or it is a faculty or something. So there are various expectations from patients and doctors also, and what are the different problems we are going to see in the next slide. Basically, what is communication? Communication, that means to have a common. The exchange of information between individuals by means of speaking, writing, or using a common system of signs or behavior. That is called as a communication. Why it is important for us? Because the climate we live in is a complex illness and treatments, healthcare teams, increase patients' expectations nowadays, blame and complaint culture, litigations are so common, diversity of the treatment and all options, and resource limitations. These are the this is the climate where we live, and there are various myths about communication skills also. It is said that they come with the experience, or observing the seniors is important, personality trait is there. Many people say that this is a personality trait, some are God gifted or something. It is not like that. We can develop our skills over a period of time. Knowing your subject, command on English, as it is said, articulate, responding to the verbal cues, being nice, and giving time. These all are myths about the communications. Then consultation skills for young doctors. It is basically very important. As you become senior in the practice, people believe in you and people have faith. The problems that are faced in the beginning are more than when you become a senior. Patient prefers doctors who have introduced themselves. They were those who were sympathetic to the patients. They were appeared self-confident, and they listen to the patient. It is very important to listen to our patient, what he is saying, and responded to the verbal cues. Ask precise and simple questions. Otherwise, we spend 1.5 hour with one patient with only non-specific questions, and it becomes difficult. Ask precise and simple questions and did not repeat themselves. It is very important time management in our practice. Time is the great teacher, but unfortunately it kills all its peoples. It is a famous quote. And experience is the ability to commit the same mistakes with increasing confidence. And for how long on an average before a doctor interrupts the patients? Basically, primary care we take 22 seconds and secondary care 92 seconds. And this is a spontaneous talk time with our patients. What to do? What do the patients want? What are the expectations of patients from a doctor? Give me 5. These 5 things are very important while giving a consultation or while talking with the patients. Eye contact. Eye contact to the patient is very important. Otherwise, patient is talking to us and we are talking to somebody, or we are looking in the computer, in the mobile. That is not good. Partnership. Patient wants to share something with you, and patient wants wants to be a people that doctors do things with rather than do other things too. And communication, that is very important. Patients and doctors may have trouble understanding each other. And there are many barriers of communications also that will come later on. Time, it is very important. If one wish could be granted, it is more time with the doctors. Patient want more time with the doctors. And appointments, patient don't want to wait. Nowadays, gone is the era of waiting full with the patients and doctors doing something. Though appointment is very important, patients want to see their doctor within a reasonable time. Then listen to the patient. It is very important that we should listen to the patient. Most of the time, what patient is saying, the diagnosis comes from that only. They are telling us a diagnosis. The pain starts in my husband's lower back. Then it travels up the hip to his neck. Then it comes out his mouth and in my ears, and that is why I get these headaches. So if we listen to the patient's history properly, we definitely make some diagnosis or we come to the conclusion. Listening and good communication skills were widely seen not only as useful means to improve the patient experience, but also assisting diagnosis and patient concordance. That is very important, listening and good communication skills. Why bother? Why this is important to have a good communication skills? There are benefits to the patient as well as to the consultant doctor. What are the benefits to the patient? Patient's problems are identified more accurately if we have a good communication. Adherence to the treatment instructions is improved. May improve health outcomes also, better emotional health, symptom resolution and pain control, and likely to reduce the incidence of clinical error. And we have rapport with the patients also. If you call the patient by the name, Mathura Bhai, kai tumcha tras hai, then she feels that I know her, or I have a good rapport with, that is very important to have a good rapport with the patients. Then benefits for the professionals, may relieve pressure in an emotionally demanding profession. Most of the time situation becomes worse just because of lack of communication. Job satisfaction may be enhanced. Whatever we are doing, we'll be doing with a better satisfaction. Patients are less likely to complain. If you are having good communication, you have good rapport, and go to the level of the patient. What is the level of understanding of that patient, and then talk accordingly, and many of the problems are solved automatically. Reduce likelihood of being sued. Litigations are more common nowadays because of all the things, and if you are very good with, friendly with the patient, most of the times litigations are avoided. Evidence of benefits, there are various papers and evidence-based literature on evidence of the benefits to the patients as well as doctors regarding them. What stops us about the communications, as I talk, there are many barriers which stop us from communicating with the patients. You have to speak a little more clearly. Most of the times we talk what patient doesn't understand, language problem is there or something is there, and patient doesn't get. Then there are different points like lack of skills, how to communicate, inadequate knowledge and training, that is again important. Then undervaluing the importance of communicating, and lack of time. Most of the times we see the OPD of 100, 150, and then we behave like a general practitioner. We give 1 or 2 minutes to the patients, or we call 5 patients in our consulting, and then we start talking to every patient, and then it becomes a mesh. Then lack of time, uncomfortable topics, and lack of confidence. These are the barriers preventing a good communication. Tiredness or stress. If you are not planning your work, you are overworking, then you become tired, and then we shout on the patients, we shout on our assistants, and that becomes difficult. Then language barriers. Most of the times, overseas doctors or patients, or if you are practicing in some other area where that is not your mother tongue, language barrier is also there. Personality and class differences between doctors and patients. Then which sort of patients you are seeing. And as I said, that go to the level of that understanding of the patient and then talk. So that becomes easy to talk with them. Concerns regarding confidentiality, they are very important. And lack of knowledge of illness and condition, that is again one factor which is barrier in communicating. How to communicate better? This has been module Kalamazoo consensus statement, where he has given essential components of a good consultation, or how to build a doctor-patient relationship. That is very important. Opening the discussion and gathering information about the disease, and at the same time we have to learn about the psychology of the patient and relatives also. That is very important. Opening the discussion and gathering information, understanding the patient's perspective, what he wants, what are his expectations, sharing information regarding his disease and everything, reaching agreement on the treatment treatment, we have to give various options of the treatment, and we have to discuss with them. It should not be a one-way communication that I am saying plating is good. So give some options. Plating will be better, nailing will be better, plaster will be better. These are advantages, these are disadvantages, so that patient can have a decision making and make a partner him in our communication. Then closure of the discussion. Then building the relationship is very important. It reduces anxiety and distress, improves willingness to engage. Break the ice. Offer choices to see them alone first. When a child does not speak, our rapport building is very important. This is for the child, because most of this is important for pediatricians, because most of the times you have to take the history from parents, relatives or mother. That time it is very important. And open the discussion, opening statement exactly as I said. How are you, my friend? How are you? When a patient is entering, we have to welcome him with his name, or that we have to show that he is very close to us. Then most of the times it is very easy to talk. Then what can I do for you? What are your concerns about Sam? What? So these are the various things which can we do. How to involve the child by eye contact, patience, use the name, open posture, etc. These are the various ways of opening the discussion. Gathering information, listening skills. We are better in giving the knowledge, but we are not most of the times better in listening. We must listen to the patient's complaints. We must listen to the relatives, what they are saying. Show that you are listening. Non-verbal behavior is very important. Clarifying the things, summarizing the things. And this is again a model. ICE, ideas, concerns and expectations. That is very important while communicating with the patients. Rapport building is very important. Company plus privacy. Distraction, praise, explanation and reassurance. These all things are very important while doing the practice. Then sharing information. It is again one big lacuna in our practice. How to share the information, whether it is a good or bad, bad breaking news. How to share, and if we share it in a proper way, most of the times litigations and all these things. Frame your explanation, what you want to, it should be clear. And honesty is the very best policy, because if you want to hide something, patient will definitely come to know from some other person or from the outside. Better way, tell, even if you are made the complication or there is something wrong on your side, honestly commit that this has been happened and there are solutions for this, so that patient's confidence is not lost. Tell them what you are about to tell them. Find out what they know already. Build on ice. Use appropriate language. Language is very important, and use visual aids most of the times. One picture is very important than 10 sentences. So visual aids are very important in explaining the information or sharing. Check understanding of the patient, what he is understanding, or whether it is in contact with you, interested with you, not. Eye contact, asking questions, forward posture, that is very important. Offer other sources like letters, leaflets or internet for giving this thing. Then closing the consultation, it is very important. Summarizing the action plan, as I said, give them the option. Safety netting, tell them what happens next, what are going to be the sequelae or this thing in our treatment. Sharing the bad news, it is very important and aspect of our practice, sharing the bad news. Preparation, are you the right person to give the news? Then environment, ideally a quiet, comfortable private room should be preferred. Minimize interruptions. Do not appear rushed. Know as much about the case as you can start. Consider who should be there. Consider an interpreter. Most of the times the problem is solved when known person to that patient is with us while we are interpreting this thing. Then it is very, very easy to communicate with the patient. That is very important. Consider who should be there. Consider whether they may be cultural attitudes, and introduce any members of the team or students who are talking to them. Brace yourself for an emotional task. Then explore what is known by the patient or family already. Give information with honesty but sensitivity. That is very important. Show that patient that you are also sensitive. You also feel bad when some complication is there or some bad thing is there. That is also very important. Sensitivity to the patient. Try to use the simple language. Take care of the prognostication. Do not talk all hope away. Find some reason to be optimistic. Allow time for questions. Listen to what the parents say, and don't be worried by periods of silence. Then recognize and cope with the family denial. Do not impose the truth, but if patient asks, did not lie. Avoid false reassurances. Acknowledge that dealing with the uncertainty is often harder than knowing the diagnosis. Try not to let your own opinions interfere if your parents push you to make a decision for them. Give the parents sufficient information to be able to make a decision with you. Then there are various again points. Recognize and acknowledge the feelings of the parents. Show empathy. Then try not to overload the parents with too much of information. That is again, they become confused and then they start searching some other way or take some other opinion. Don't stay too long. Leave the nurse with the parents for some period of time. Most consultations should last 15 to 30 minutes. Some may last longer. Then arrange a review appointment relatively soon. Provide written information. Suggest writing down any questions. Document the notes. At review appointments, update the news. There may be ongoing bad news to communicate. Liaise with the primary healthcare teams. Those who have referred to you, also communicate to them what has happened. And consider debriefing for the staff involved and be around counseling. So these are very important points while breaking the bad news. And what is the take home message at the last? So communication skills are very important as treating skills. As I said, 85% of the soft skills and 15% of the technical skills, it comes to percentage. And talking to the patients and relatives and our colleagues is very important. Patient counseling is a very important aspect of our practice. And honesty and transparency are the important keys if we want to success for a longer period. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for listening.